My name is Sean Conley. I'm the state soybean and small grains extension specialist at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Today what we want to do is discuss some of the yellowing issues that we've seen in our early season beans in 2009. What we've generally seen has been a very cool year compared to the 2008 growing season. We're about the same for GDUs, but over the last 30 years, we're probably somewhere between 120 and 160 heat units behind. What that's really done is limited some of our growth on our soybeans that were even planted earlier. And generally what we're seeing is a lot of questions coming in related to yellow soybeans. Now if we look in this instance, what we want to do is identify and try to determine what is causing some of this yellowing. Obviously, a lot of times what we generally will hear are questions related to glyphosate injury the yellow flash with glyphosate. However, as you can see in this field, we haven't applied any glyphosate to this point. So therefore, we know it has nothing to do with chemicals. So again, what we need to do think about is in the physiology of the soybean plant and what's going on. So here's a good example of a soybean plant where we see the newest trifoliate that is open is very yellow and chlorotic. Okay, and this is basically a V2 soybean plant. Now, if we dig up a soybean plant, and what we really wanted to do is it kind of looks like it's almost nitrogen stressed. And as we identify this plant, what we're looking at is basically nitrogen coming into this plant and where it's caused by. If we look at the cotyledons, we see that we basically almost utilized all of the nutrients on our cotyledons. And generally a soybean plant will depend upon the cotyledons until it hits about the V1 growth stage. At that point, these cotyledons are basically sloughed off. You see how they're going to be falling off the soybean plant very quickly. So in between when the cotyledons are stopped being a function of soybean plant and nodulation occurs, we sometimes see this yellow coloration. If we look here, and we split a nodule, if we look, it's still relatively white inside. And what that has indicated to us is that the soybean plant has not started fixing nitrogen on its own. So in a sense, what we've seen this last year is due to the slower growth, the cotyledons basically are no longer of use to the soybean plant, and nodulation hasn't been occurred, so we are, in a sense, lacking nitrogen in these V2 soybean plants. However, within the next 5 days at max, these soybean plants will begin to actively fix nitrogen, and this yellow coloration in these trifoliates will disappear, and growth will remain as usual.